but kind of bold technique that was implemented into modern graphic psychology, and it is called comic book therapy. I do have a few comic books that, if you want to look through them, pass them around. Comic book therapy is not an entirely new concept. It initially started in the 1920s with black and white comic strips, mostly used for entertainment, but now it's used for a form of expressing emotions, and comic books like Batman or the Peanuts help in the presenting, allowing patients to connect their own personal lives with the story or the character. And today, comic books are more within selective topics of social change, economy, and many other things. Comic book therapy is a form of art therapy for those who are going under rehabilitation or who have already completed rehabilitation. And it helps them to express personal experiences through a narrative within a comic book format. And as a therapeutic tool, it helps creating or reading comic books help with coping and relating to identical experiences that would be in the storyline. And they also help to develop closer relationships between the patient and the psychiatrist. Emotionally, the patients connect themselves with the character or storyline to help them see the choices they made or didn't make. And it can be used as a medical tool in graphic medicine for students. And it's a way out of, out-of-the-box teachings that can be used in everyday medical field and vary to any patient's specific needs. Current uses today in graphic medicine for comic book therapy is, like in the last slide, used for educational purposes, mostly for medical students, and therapeutic for patients in creating parallels between themselves and the story. Comic book therapy is also used as an effective coping mechanism, like stress relief, PTSD, depression, fatal illness, and other things. Usually it's used on younger children, but now they're seeing if it works for PTS victims of really any age. Creating versus reading. All right, so creating a comic book is a therapeutic coping mechanism that goes beyond the usual text-based storyline telling. And it can lead to cognitive and emotional breakthroughs. This allows for a simultaneous expression of body image, verbal expression, physical action, and emotions. Creating a comic book is a way for patients to relate their personal experiences from past or present and develop a plot that imitates their own life. Reading a comic book can help patients from a wide range of topics like cancer, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, eating disorders, schizophrenia, and many more. It also helps patients create parallels with characters that have similar diagnosis or personal history. They are encouraged to read them critically to find these parallels and the hidden meanings and narratives in the graphics. And in medical opinion, these are both great tools in graphic therapy. It's more than just a book. It can help mentally, emotionally. Yeah.
Yeah.